Let's go ahead and begin now with the ever-growing question of how much can we continue to borrow, right? How much more money can we continue to print, even worse? And what happens if we suddenly get hit with a recession during all of this, especially when you consider that while, and I mentioned this a little while ago, our national debt is $22 trillion, which is crazy in and of itself, by the way. You know what's even crazier? Our corporate debt. Our corporate debt is $9 trillion. And why is it so high? Well, if you think about it, it's not hard to figure out. You don't need to go to MIT to figure this one out, because we've kept interest rates so low for so long now, and we're apparently about to cut them again, according to the Wall Street Journal. We've allowed corporations to essentially use government money to just blow up their companies. Here's the question. Is this sustainable, right? Joining us now are the hosts of Boom Bust here on RT America, Christy I and Daniel Brito. I'm so glad you guys are here for this conversation, because I think this is something that's perplexing a lot of Americans, and certainly it's been getting a lot of ink, and a lot of folks on YouTube have been talking about this. So let's begin with the corporate debt. If you could, Daniel, help us understand why this corporate debt issue that I'm hearing a lot of economists talk about could be a real pitfall, a real problem for us.
Well, you know, we'll be reporting on this later today, but the economy right now, you know, it's been on a short sugar high from the Trump tax cuts, but now we're seeing a lot of structural weakness here. We saw underwhelming jobs report today, 75,000 jobs created, where we were expecting, economists were expecting something closer to 175,000. Mm-hmm. We're seeing a real drag finally kick in from these trade wars. And so we're at a point where there was, you know, this sort of candy for everybody with the Trump tax cut, and there was a lot of stock buyback. But now the conditions are getting a little more precarious, so people may be a little overextended.
Here's the situation with this, Christy. It's fine, and I think everybody looks at these artificial numbers or artificial ways of getting there, and they say, okay, that happened. But here's the problem, and here's my question about this, and I think it's the question of many Americans. If tomorrow we start to hit that recession that everyone's talking mm-hmm. about, or worse, right? We go into a deep dive or deep spin. Because we are where we are, because we have this debt, and because the interest rates have remained low, will it be harder to be able to get out of that situation?
Absolutely. It's going to be tremendously hard, because if you think about it, right now, the government is actually using all of its debt to finance its debt. Right now, you're paying $1 billion a day to simply finance $22 trillion worth of debt outstanding. So that $1 billion every single day going out for debt servicing, that's not capital being put to good use. That's simply capital used to repay your debt lenders.
So in other words, if you guys who are listening to us at home, right? Mom and dad with your kids sitting around the kitchen table. At the end of the day, what you do then is you continue to borrow more and more money till it gets to the point where all you're doing is paying the interest on the money that you've borrowed. I don't know anybody out there who runs a small business or is an American running a household who would do something that crazy. Yet what you just said is that we Americans are doing that.
Yeah.
Our government is doing that.
$1 billion a day, right out the door.
So in the past, guys, we would get into recessions and we'd find a way of getting out of them. This time, if we get into a recession, it would be more difficult to get out of it. Explain that to us.
So right now, it's going to be much more difficult because the government doesn't have enough cushion. They don't have enough money to actually try to stimulate the economy. Right now, all they're trying to do is just simply keep the ship afloat and pay out the debt financing. They are going to lack the tools to create more economic stimulus. They can't give any more tax cuts, because if they cut tax to stimulate the economy, then their debt will increase even more.
But Dan, I'll disagree with Christy and I'll bring it to you. So we get into another recession, we'll just print more money. We do that all the time, and somehow we'll just lower the interest rates again, right? Why not?
Well, the problem is that deficits are supposed to be, in the classical sense, they're supposed to be counter-cyclical measures. That is, you run deficits when the economy is in a recession, mm-hmm. so you can sort of restore that demand that's been lost and get the economy back to the status quo when everything equalizes and stabilizes. But they passed a tax cut, a massive Trump tax cut, in the middle of a recovery, as you noted. So then they don't have that arrow in their quiver, so to speak, if and when the downturn comes. And it may be coming sooner than they expect.
But what happens if we actually hit this downturn and we continue to actually, prior to it, bring down the interest rates. I read in the front page, I don't know if you guys have seen this, I wish I had it with me. Front page, Wall Street Journal says, right? Am I right? Wall Street Journal saying that the Fed is getting ready to cut interest rates once again. Mm-hmm. If they continue to cut interest rates, what do you do? You can't continue to cut something that's already cut to the bone, right?
Exactly. So therefore, it's going to be much harder to dig yourself out of the hole. And so right now, the U.S. currently is relying upon itself to expand their GDP in order to get out of recession. That's always been the prior way, and that's how you really evaluate the health of an economy. You look at their debt to GDP ratio. Right now, the U.S. economy is currently at a 108% debt to GDP ratio.
Yeah.
There are only four countries with a higher ratio, and that's going to be Portugal, Greece, Italy, and Japan. And we
really?
All know the first three countries. We all know the first three countries, they are known to have austerity measures. They are known to go into bankruptcy. Those are the only four countries in the world that run a higher
ratio. So you just said that we're among the top five with the worst GDP to debt ratio in the world
debt
right
GDP,
now.
Yes.
We're right there with Greece.
Yes.
That's not good, Dan.
Right, but this is an example of American exceptionalism that is arguably, you know, justifiable. That you know, the U.S. is a much larger economy than, say, Portugal. You know, so the dollar is the world's reserve currency. There's all these privileges that the U.S. gets for its position, and one of them is that you get to run that high deficit without running the same risks that a smaller country with a weaker economy might. And you know, Christie rightly put this in perspective. You know, debt to GDP, which is at 108% of GDP right now, you know, as recently as 2012, it was about at 100, equal to GDP. So it's about where it's been for the past 10 years.
Here's the other thing we haven't spoken about that troubles me as well. So many corporations have been riding this gravy train of low interest rates and have essentially built fortunes, including people, not just corporations, off of these low interest rates. And they're also buying back their own stock a lot. What happens if we get into a recession and those guys all start going belly up?
Well, right now, the banks that are actually financing them, their security measures for evaluating these debts have already eroded tremendously since 2017. And that's when I feel like people don't remember history quite as well, because back then, you look at the debt, you evaluate, you see if it's secure or not, AAA, BBB, or whatever. And right now, the rating agencies, they're getting a little lax again. So right now, they're issuing debt that are not supposed to be AAA or BBB. They're actually supposed to be a lot worse.
So they rated companies almost as a favor when they didn't really deserve it, and that's what got us into the big meltdown of 2008,
exactly.
Right? And so you're saying, oh my God, this could happen again, right? That would be the big fear.
Mm-hmm. That would be the fear, but right now the argument to that is saying that right now there hasn't been any defaults yet. The default rate is actually quite low, so it shows that the companies are performing well. So far, earnings have shown that earnings are pretty stable, so far it has worked.
Christie, Dan, great stuff, great conversation. Thank you so much for your expertise. I'm Rick Sanchez. You found us on YouTube, and that's awesome. But you know what? I'm also live every night at 7 and 8 p.m. Eastern on DirecTV and Dish and cable and satellite, the RT app. Oh, and Pluto TV. I'll see you there.